moving on.
There are no transitional fossils that anybody can point to.
Perhaps the problem is, Glenn doesn't know what a transitional fossil is.
Many of these creatures that are supposed to be tens or hundreds of millions of years old and extinct have been found alive today and exactly the same, like a coelacanth. That was supposed to have been dead for 70 million years, and gee, all of a sudden they find one.
Meet Glenn W., our first nominee for Dim Bulb of the Week. He's a fairly typical YouTube creationist.
You know, evolution scratch their head. They go, wow, everything else has changed so much.
Presumably, when Glenn says evolutionist, he's referring to someone who accepts the validity of science and actually may understand it a bit. But it's not a particularly important point, so we'll let it pass. On the other hand, he doesn't understand that the word coelacanth doesn't refer to a single genus or species. It refers to an entire order of fish. We'll get back to that in a moment. Andy has a fairly typical creationist misconception of evolution, which nowhere suggests that organisms have to change in a major way over millions of years. If an organism is well adapted to an environment, it may not change very much over time. For example, linguloid brachiopods have been around since the mid-Cambrian at least, and they really haven't changed very much. It is surprising that a living coelacanth was found in the 1930s, but let's consider the environment it inhabits. I've often mentioned that there's natural bias in the fossil record toward shallow marine invertebrates. As a matter of fact, the vast majority of fossils known come from shallow marine environments. Latimeria does not occupy a shallow marine environment. It lives in relatively remote, relatively deep waters that until recently were inaccessible to man. And whatever its evolutionary path may have been, it's unlikely to have been preserved in the fossil record, and even if it were, it's less than likely that it would be accessible or discovered by man. In the distant geological past, the relatives of Latimeria occupied a wide range of environments. They were quite common in the late Paleozoic era, from 300 to 400 million years ago. They became less so in the early Mesozoic era, and eventually they disappeared from the fossil record about 70 million years ago. A final word on so-called living fossils. Living fossils are extant species representing once common groups that have largely gone extinct. A typical characteristic of a living fossil is that they tend to be found in very remote locations. That's true of Latimeria. That's true of the ginkgo trees and the dawn redwoods, which were originally discovered in remote locations in China. It's true of the tuatara, the small reptile, living only in New Zealand.